Please welcome Tex Perkins in an amazing jacket.
Hello, everyone.
Wonderful to have you here. The Honeymoon Is Over. It was obviously such a huge album. It won 5 ARIA awards. Where do you keep them all? Where are they?
Well, I didn't have any ARIA awards to take home. I actually...
You weren't trusted with them?
Well, no, I can't be trusted with them. At the awards night, we went to some after parties and I was carrying 2 around and...
Never saw them again.
Well... I left suddenly and left them behind.
And, you left them behind?
Yeah, well, one of them got picked up.
Yeah.
But one of them was picked up by some dastardly people that held it for ransom.
Oh, no.
Stole an ARIA award.
Indeed, it was held for ransom.
How much was the ransom?
Well, it was a list of demands that was... They contacted Triple J and they said, we have a list of demands. First of all... Michael Bolton's work visa must be terminated. We had no control over that. Another demand that they had was James Cruikshank, our keyboard player, be reinstated in the band. He wasn't out of the band. He'd been in a car accident. That's why he wasn't at the awards.
Oh,
right.
So anyway, they got what they wanted.
Yeah, he came back.
They got what they wanted, but for some reason we forgot about. We didn't follow it up. We didn't.
So you never got it back.
Well, last December, a whole lot of people started contacting me saying, there's an ARIA award on Facebook Marketplace.
No way.
A song of the year. It's up for $1. It says, found in a bin.
No way. You offered 50 cents and the rest was history, I hope.
Anyway, a whole lot of people just attacked this guy, saying, how dare you?
Yeah.
Give that ARIA award back. And he got this so much... heat from it that he just shut that down.
Okay.
And luckily, our bass player, Kenny Lee G, contacted this guy and got to him and talked him off the ledge.
Great.
And... he gave it back for a slab of VB.
Oh,
fantastic.
And this is actually how Facebook Marketplace really works nowadays anyway. But Tex, tell us, what was it like to be a frontman of a band in the 90s? 90s was a fun time.
He can't remember.
The 90s.
Oh, the 90s.
It was like the 60s, but upside down.
That sounds fun.
I need a shirt.
I feel like the statute of limitations on a lot of the more, you know, mischievous... things you may have done, they've expired legally. I'm not a lawyer.
But, oh, indeed. Yeah.
So, like, you know, what kind of mischief did you get up to?
Oh, just the usual stuff. Just, alcohol is ever present in the music industry. Probably in the television industry as well. I don't know.
It is Friday night.
Yeah, this isn't water.
Ask Graham Kennedy. You can't do a good show without a couple under your belt. But I don't know. You drink, you have a few too many, and things get broken. I'm not sure what else.
You lose some ARIA awards.
Yeah, exactly.
But you're obviously still enjoying what you're doing. I mean, it is 30 years on, right? That's what we're celebrating here tonight as well.
Exactly. The success of that album probably enabled me to have just the career I really wanted, which was just to be a working musician.
Yeah.
And it gave me a profile that, you know, today I can just, you know, I still work and people always, you know, reference that. But, but I've done many things since then. But, it was a significant... time and it's a very significant album.
We were just talking about Taylor Swift and we did some quick numbers. $150 cheapest ticket, $1,500 the most expensive, and she's doing, what, 10 shows?
Yeah. No, only 5. Yeah.
5 shows. So we worked out that's something like $75 million. When you look at that, you must look at that and think, boy, wow. Give some of that to me.
I haven't looked at that, Steve. But,
funny that, Tex.
This is news to me.
Is she any... Well, I asked
let me write those.
Is she any
down.
Good? Is she any good?
She is.
Really
she absolutely
good?
Is.
Really good?
My daughter's a big Taylor Swift and a big Harry Styles fan.
Got it.
She's introduced me to a lot of that. They're both... Yeah, they're both in the pop world, but they're both very musically driven. They're not manufactured artists. Yeah. They're real they write their own stink, the music. They have real bands
that they
continue to work with, the same people. And I have total respect for Tay-Tay.
Thank you.
And Hazza.
I didn't know that until tonight. Tay-Tay.
Tay-Tay? What do you mean? Surprise, you're a huge Swiftie.
No, I'm not.
Oh, have you ever actually
Is that what they call them?
Swifties. Yes, yes. You've just announced yourself as one right now.
Absolutely.
Have you ever seen Taylor or Harry?
I went to Harry with my daughter in, when was it, April?
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah.
I realised I'd never been to a pop concert. I've been to a lot of rock concerts.
Well, this is the thing, right? And also because you're always on stage.
I've seen other acts, but I realise there's a really big difference between a pop concert and a rock concert. Like, the fans are just, they're singing every word. To an annoying point, you're like, where you kind of want to, can I hear him?
But that's what they're going to do for you.
This is
when they put this up.
This is why we're here. This is the vinyl. It is, of course. This is
it.
We're all Texies here.
It.
Tex Perkins, the 30th anniversary edition of The Honeymoon Is Over is out right now.
On vinyl for the first time.
We're all Texies. Tex Perkins, we love your work and we love this.
So good. Thanks. Tex Perkins, thank you so much for joining us.